Former Memphis Mayor Willie Herenton made a similar call to action at Mayor Strickland's annual prayer breakfast at the beginning of this year, calling for 10,000 people to become volunteers.
But Dr. Herenton went even further, calling specifically on African Americans to step up and intervene, saying crime in Memphis is a black problem. Dr. Herenton joins us live this morning on Live at 9. Dr. Herenton, Happy New Year. Always good to have you back here on Live at 9.
Happy New Year. It's good to be here.
Thank you. What exactly did you mean by that? A lot of people will hear, well, this is a black problem, and others will say, well, wouldn't you think this is a community-wide problem? What is it?
It is clearly, Alex and Mary Beth, a black problem. It's interesting, following your news announcements this morning on the shootings in the two apartment complex. A couple of nights ago, an 81-year-old lady was tragically killed. Last week, we've just had shootings, murders, homicides almost every night. What is interesting, and it is very factual, when you talk about 228 homicides in 2016, 200 of those homicides were involving perpetrators that were black and the victims were black. Now you tell me that is not a black problem. It is a black problem in the sense that the disproportionate number of homicide victims are black. And we must face up to that. What we're calling for, quite frankly, is for the black community, especially black men, to take ownership and accountability for this particular problem. What I'm encountering from some of my distractors is this, and it's a syndrome. There are many blacks who blame the white man for the condition that we're facing today, and they blame poverty. Poverty, there are a lot of there are millions of people that are in poverty. But because you're in poverty does not give you the right to kill. It does not give you the right to take other folks' property.
But Mayor, you're saying people should step up now, a call for action, so to speak. What makes you think they will be willing to kind of come forward at this moment?
This is real interesting. We're launching a campaign. It's black men stepping up and reaching out. In 2 weeks, we will have an announcement that will involve prominent black ministers that will demonstrate to the Memphis public how we will achieve 10,000 volunteers. We call this project the Gideon 300, and this is all biblically referenced. We will garner the support of black men. They will reach out as mentors. They will step out. We will work with the city of Memphis and all of these other agencies that need volunteers. It's time for the church community, for the voices of the clergy to be heard, and action plans. This is just one phase of New Path. Also, we want to reform the juvenile justice system. What we're finding in the juvenile justice system is that many of the young boys that are incarcerated, the recidivism rate is high. They graduate from juvenile court into adult prison. So New Path is going to build two 60-bed residential facilities that will educate and rehabilitate offenders such that they are restored to be decent boys who grow into be decent men. Yes.
This is obviously long-term solution because, you know, we didn't get here like that, and in order to mentor, it's going to be harder to mentor a 25-year-old who's already down that path than it is a 15-year-old or 12-year-old. So it's a great long-term solution. What would you do if you were mayor today to solve the problem that we have right now, in addition to all the suggestions that would be a more long-term solution, which we certainly need?
First of all, Mary Beth, as I've said to the public, you cannot hold Mayor Strickland accountable for the rash of homicides in the Memphis community. Many of these homicides, as you've reported, I think 75% of them are gang-related. Some involve domestic violence and some in drug situation. The mayor cannot be held responsible for the personal behavior of individuals. What the mayor can do, and he's doing it, he has a plan to get more policemen. Let me say this. More policemen will not solve the homicide problems, okay? Right. There are no quick fixes. Anybody
so
who comes
no
to tell you.
So there's no immediate solution.
No, of course not. I mean, what we've got to do, we've got to change the paradigm. We got to attack the root causes. And of course, poverty is a factor. Low educational attainment, blighted neighborhoods, fatherless boys, all of these are factors. But Mary Beth, we don't have time for generational change to occur. We've got to immediately put some bandage approaches to stop the hemorrhage.
So Dr. Herenton, is New Path getting back on juvenile reform? Is this something that you're trying to do on your own, but aren't you going to need support from the city council? Are you going to need support from the Shelby County Commission and others?
And what has been the reaction?
And have you run into any roadblocks so far?
That's a very good question. In order for the New Path mission, which is a nonprofit, for it to realize its goals, it must partner with the Tennessee Department of Children's Services, the Department of Human Services, Shelby County Government. There must be a major health care provider, and there are other agencies, the Board of Education, the school district. We must have partnership agreements and the juvenile court authorities. So there are about five or six governmental units that must partner with New Path in order to bring about reform.
So what are they saying to you so far, some of those entities?
Well,
that
let me
just
say the Shelby County government has already passed a resolution. Mayor Luttrell has given us strong endorsements. We are in discussions with the juvenile court judge. We've made some overtures to the Tennessee Department of Children's Services. And we've talked to the Tennessee Black Caucus. So there, and we've met with the leadership of the Crime Commission. So there have been some ongoing discussions, but this is a game changer. What we're talking about is education, rehabilitation, dealing with the adverse childhood experiences that over 50% of these adjudicated offenders are suffering. And the other point I want to make, did you know that currently in Memphis and Shelby County, there are no beds for juvenile offenders?
Right. They have to go, what, 100 miles away?
The closest location is Wilder, and I believe 90% of the juvenile offenders are from Memphis and Shelby County.
So they have no family support.
They have no family engagement.
Are you impatient with the process? Because Lord knows you spend a lot of time in government. You know it's slow. How impatient are you with the process?
Mary Beth, that is a very good question because I'm irritated that the governmental officials that I have to work with, they have no sense of urgency. They are moving at snail pace. As I stated last week, I think they're floundering. I'm much more aggressive, the urgency of the moment. So to answer your question, I'm very impatient with their lack of urgency.
Will you stay in touch with us about your projects and where things stand and what comes next?
Yes, sir. Be glad to.
All right.
Please do.
Dr. Willie Herenton, thank you.
Thank you so much. Always good to see you.
All right.